Okay, everyone, welcome back to another video. Today's video is a figure review on the Star Wars Vintage Collection Panda Bubba or Rawless Man. Before anything, I am just gonna go straight into the packaging. There is a Star Wars logo, Luke and Leia in the corner right there. His name, where the figure would be, the Kenner logo. A nice picture of Panda Bubba. On the back is the Vintage Collection logo. His name again. He is VC number 70. The picture of the order figure. A read-up which you guys can pause and read. The original Panda Bubba card, 1978-1979. The other figures in the way of a Hoth Rebel Soldier. Basila Shawn, Ada Secura, Naminoa, and 50 First Legion Clone Trooper. The only one I have out of all these is Ada Secura. Not in a rush to get any of them, any others. I would like to get him eventually, and I want a carded Ada, so. So that's packaging. Panda's articulation is ball jointed head, ball and shoulders, ball and elbows, swivel on the wrist, swivel on the waist, swivel on the hips, ball hinge knees, and ball hinge ankles. So this is like the definitive Panda Bubba. It's probably the best one there is. The detail on him is really nice. On the detail on his jacket, his shirt, his belt, his pants and boots. Pretty good. The face sculpt, I think, looks a lot like the character. It's pretty dead on. So, yeah. His accessories are a cup, which he can hold in his hand. Pretty good. He holds it better in that hand. Then he comes with a blaster. Now this is not his because I got this figure loose in a trade and the person didn't have the blaster. This is actually the TIE Fighter pilot's blaster, but I believe it's the same one. Now you either can put it in his hand. Like so. Or you can put it in his holster. As so. I don't display him with this gun just because. And he also comes with alternate hands and arms right here. Now, before I put those on, I do just want to make a quick comparison to the original 1970s Panda Bubba figure. Great update. It's just a major, major, major update. I mean, the original one doesn't even look like him. In the face it does, but his face wasn't green. There's no even comparing the two. I mean, I still love this figure very much. I think it's one of the best vintage figures in my opinion, but obviously the new one's better. And then in Power of the Force, one came out and there were a lot of retools and repacks of this one. I don't have all of them, but this was the first. This, for a Power of the Force figure, is a pretty good figure, but obviously the Vintage Collection one is better. So this comparison. Now I'm gonna take off his arm. All you have to do is pop this arm off, and it's on a ball joint, and you can put this arm on, and you can take the hand off, the arm off, the arm part off, and reenact the scene where he gets his hand cut off. And he also comes with his flipper hand. I guess that's what they used before. And if you put this arm, if you display this arm on with the flipper arm, this he only has a swivel in the arm. And he also comes another flipper. So yeah. I don't display it. I display him with his normal looking hand on and this arm on. I don't display him like that, but he looks pretty cool still. So yeah, he's one of the harder vintage collection figures to find, so definitely if you find him, I definitely recommend him. I highly recommend him. He's really awesome. He looks great next to the vintage collection. Dr. Evazon, of course. Very happy to have both of them. So yeah. This was a figure review on the Star Wars the Vintage Collection Ponda Baba. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to my channel, and as always, may the Force be with you.